Hi everyone, I'm Grahtles and welcome to City Skylines. So today we're going to do something a little different. I'm going to start a little mini series on the editor, basically the assets editor in City Skylines. Reason being is I just started on PC and there's so many mods in the workshop and stuff, and there's so many little things that I would like to do for myself. And learning with the asset editor, I've learned quite a few little tricks that I can do and have my own assets that don't max out everything like the Steam Workshop mods. So let's go ahead and jump into it. We're just going to click new. It doesn't matter what the theme is, not for highways and parks and stuff. So we're going to start with the first one, which is intersections. And then we'll go from there. All right, so here we are. And the first thing we get is intersections. And that's the one we're going to use right now. I think I'll make another episode on parks and buildings and props and stuff like that. So today, let's just start with intersections. All right. So one of the biggest things that I like is to have the roundabouts, especially the pre-made roundabouts. The only thing is, I don't like the road sticking out. When I'm trying to, whether it's a large one or a small one, when I'm trying to place this in, I end up having to delete way more than I should just because of the sheer size of the road sticking out. So you constantly gotta have to like maneuver it and get it in or delete more to get it. So with the small one, we do have lovely little trees that are the old kind of trees. But if we go in, delete the trees, delete the roads, and then we go back to our just gravel roads here, and we just brace it from the middle. So this way it doesn't distort when we put a road on, like that or like that. It will make it so much nicer and smaller and tighter to get into a space. So my goal is to take just the random roundabouts that we get. Now this one has the regular one-way roads. I'm going to upgrade this also to the highway. So it just makes it a little faster, smoother, no walking paths. So now that I've done this, I can go in, I can zoom in, right there, take a picture. So this is not going on the workshop. It's just a roundabout for myself to use. So I'm gonna save the asset and I'll just save it as my small RA. And by putting my there, when I go to search for things and find it or stuff, if I just put mine or my, I'll know how to find the stuff that I've made. Alright, so now that I put it here and the save as here, I'm just going to switch through the pictures to find the roundabout. You could put a description, but all I need is the asset name and I know what it is. And I'm just going to hit save. Now, I don't have to leave this area. I could just go grab the bulldozer and delete everything. I'm going to go back in. I'm going to grab the large roundabout and pretty much do the same exact thing. So the pictures really didn't matter there because I already had the small roundabout, but I have it named large roundabout, so it doesn't matter too much. So we're going to go back in and delete this. And let's go take another look at other options. So if we take, say, a highway, and we run it down, and we pretty much make it just like we would see in the game. Now, they're pretty close. Pretty much like they are. We can pretty much make our own highway exit, and it'll be pre-made and set for us to do. One thing that I think would be nice is maybe a trumpet. So if I go here, let's grab my keyboard. It's a little farther away than I would have liked, but all right, we page up. 1, 2, that should get us across. Yeah. So if we go like that, and we can keep them fairly close. And come on. Sometimes you have to go a little further out because they want to snap to each other. Come on. There we go. All right. And let's just bring these out just a little bit more too. Probably after this circle, we'll go 1, 2. That should be enough, I think. Hopefully. And then all we're going to do is come down, take this right when it gets to the point where it brings up that highlight right here. So if you see when you, let me turn it this way. It might be easier to show you. So if you come out and it pops up that white line on both sides, right there, right there. We're just going to turn it in and pop up the white lines again. See it flashing? And then do it again. And then come down. And then right about, you don't want to come up to where it brings up the, right there. See it flash? There. And then bring it back. And then page this down. And that should bring us straight in like that. So on the other side, we're going to bring this down right before the line. And then bring it around. Right before the line, bring it down. And right there, bring it around and page it down. And then you can just run it there. So we used the 2-lane on this, and you could bring this one as far as you like it. We have to change the direction on this one. And now you could leave it open-ended because you don't know how far you want to run it down your highway or anything like that. On this side, we're just going to, we're going to come down by 12, page it down. Right there, and then let go, there we go, bring it back up. Now, you can also add just a little bit to each side of this. Come on, get off of there. See, it constantly wants to pop to that. Ugh, it's annoying. But anyway, we'll just leave it like that. That'll be fine. So change the direction. Make sure you got that done. There we go. So on this side, we're going to do something similar. We're going to go straight from here to about there. On this side, we'll do the same thing. We'll just come in straight. And then we're just going to curve this to there. And then we're going to come on the other side and do exactly the same thing. Go straight. Let's come in. And we'll go to right there. Turn it around. And come down straight. And we'll leave a little bit more space. Let's delete that. Yeah, that's better. And then we'll just curve it. So now you have open spaces for you to hook these into the roads. So that's our little trumpet. We'll take a photo. And let's go ahead and save it. So now let's get a picture. There we go. And the other one, whoops, went past it. And save. So now we have a large roundabout, a small roundabout, and a trumpet. So those are pretty basic main ways to get things like this in your city. And I will open up my city and I'll show you where to find them and how to use them. Okay, so here we are in my city of Lachlan. And I'm just trying to find a place that maybe we could put that trumpet in. I don't see really anywhere, but we'll figure out something. It's not going to stay anyway, so we might just get rid of this intersection and we'll try throwing it in there just to show you. But for the roundabouts, let's take a look now. So if we wanted to put a roundabout, say, right in here, let's go in. We have it on pause. It doesn't matter. I'm not saving it anyway, but we'll just show you. So if I only delete that much road in there, and we go to roundabouts, now you'll see I have my small roundabout, my large roundabout. So say we wanted a small one here. I can line this up so much better now than, and you, it would even connect, and you can even line it up that way. So just putting it in is so much easier. Now, some people don't like to attach it with the road like this, and they'd like to put in, say, you know, the one-way and the one-way. You could still do that, not a problem. But see, now connecting this road, so much easier. Now, if you get rid of these braces, that's another thing too. But I didn't line it up with this road. I kind of lined it up with that road. But I'll show you this way. If we go like this, and we take the small roundabout again, and you can actually line it up right with this. So just turning it doesn't take up a lot of space, as you can see. You could kind of line that up pretty nicely right there. And now put your four lane or your six lane. That happens to be a six lane. And that. And then you could still run this one right into here. You can curve it anything you want. So, yep, that works quite well. And it's all pre-made. You don't have to worry about putting it in. Let's come down over to here. And let's just get rid of all this and put in that trumpet really quick. So give me 1 minute. I'll be right back. So here we are with the trumpet interchange. And let's just see. We're going to interfere with a couple of things here. So let me just delete a little bit more. Okay, so there we go. So let's grab the trumpet. We could actually connect it down in here if we wanted to, but we could just put it, say, right there. And let's connect the roads. Highway. So they might not perfectly line up, but let me control A this a second. There we go. We'll just put that in. It's not perfectly lined up, but just for these demonstration purposes, it'll be fine. There we go. And we'll do just something quick over here. And then down in here, let's take a look. We'll just delete this. And what we'll do is, let's come into our highway roads. We'll take this. Let's actually upgrade these to the wrong thing. There we go. And upgrade these. Well, we're actually downgrading them. And let's go straight. Let's see. We'll just take that. Go like that. All right. And let's just turn the game on and you can see how it functions. And we cut the electric. I know we did. All right, calm down. We'll get you hooked up. There we go. Everybody's happy. So, it might not be working wonderfully. We're getting a lot of traffic. But as you can see, it's a functioning trumpet. No problem. And, yeah. So, that's how you kind of use your asset editor to just make things a little simpler on you later on, that you can have this all preset and ready to go. And you find them in your highways. So everything will be right there. And you can use them at your, you know, in your own cities. Super easy. So if you like my content and you would like to see more, especially like these kind of things, let me know. And like, subscribe, comment, and share. I will see you next time. Thanks. Bye.